are these doomed landscapes. When we look at atolls or atolls, they seem to be at really high risk for changes to climate and sea level rise. As a coastal geomorphologist, I like to understand processes driving landscape change. When I'm studying atolls or atolls, one method that I use a lot of is called computational modeling. And what we can do is track through time how the surface area of these islands have changed, and trying to then compare that to what might be driving that change. A lot of the research that has been done has used hand tracing methods, but because it's so time intensive, what my lab's been trying to do is use machine learning to try and automate that analysis on a global scale. We've actually created a database that lists almost 600 atolls. These landscapes are considered highly vulnerable to a lot of the different aspects of climate change, from sea level rise to ocean acidification hurting the coral reefs, to changes in storm climates, meaning more hurricanes potentially hitting these landscapes and kind of wrecking infrastructure. So by understanding kind of what might drive changes to these landscapes, then we're hopefully going to be able to predict how they will survive or not, which of course has huge implications for the people that live there currently and hopefully will be able to continue living there. And we see areas where we have land growth, even though there's really high rates of sea level rise. So they may not be doomed. They may actually be a lot more resilient than we think they are.